From a forgotten river to a prehistoric whale, there are 7 mind-boggling Sahara Desert discoveries. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe to They Will Kill You. Hit the like button and request any topics you'd like to learn about in the comments section below. Number 7. Lost River. Because of shifts in the Earth's axis, as it rotates around the sun, the Sahara goes through a 41,000-year cycle of desert and savanna grassland. The borders of the sands have shifted due to climate changes spanning back millions of years. By looking at the desert's history, scientists have determined that the world's 12th largest drainage basin once flowed through it. The Tamanrasett River was discovered based on evidence from an undersea canyon off the coast of Mauritania. The enormous river is believed to have once carved a path through the canyon. It flowed through West Africa as recently as 5,000 years ago, and its existence was confirmed by a Japanese satellite. By using microwave sensing, the satellite detected the fossil water still flowing underneath the Saharan sands. Number 6. NABTA stones. Starting from around the 10th millennium BC, a region in southern Egypt known as NABTA PLAYA started to receive more rainfall. A lake subsequently began to take shape, which attracted populations of cattle herders. By the 7th millennium BC, their settlements had grown larger and more organized, even more so than those closer to the Nile Valley. The inhabitants of NABTA PLAYA relied on deep wells that held water throughout the year and built stone structures both above and below the ground. Then, by the 5th millennium BC, they started erecting some mysterious structures, dubbed the NABTA stones, at a site that may also have been used as a necropolis. Before we move on, answer this question. What do the NABTA stones represent? A. Worshipped idols. B. Astronomical devices. C. Places of sacrifice. D. Structures used in home building. Let us know what you think in the comments section below and stay tuned to find out the right answer. Number 5. Machimosaurus Rex. It's quite incredible to think that the Sahara, one of the world's hottest, driest, and emptiest places, was once teeming with marine life. In 2016, a site in Tunisia revealed the skeleton of a terrifying creature, which they dubbed Machimosaurus Rex, an apex predator at a time when the area was a lagoon facing the ocean. At over 23 feet long, it's the largest sea-dwelling crocodilian ever discovered. It's worth mentioning that the Rex is a new addition to the Machimosaurus genus, which was already known. However, these creatures were believed to have disappeared during the extinction event of the late Jurassic period. That being said, Machimosaurus was traced back to the early Cretaceous about 146 to 100 million years ago. The fact that the giant crocodilian survived the Triassic-Jurassic extinction provided further insight into the event. Number 4. Eye of the Sahara. Also known as the Rishat structure, the Eye of the Sahara is a blue circular formation that resembles a gigantic bullseye with a 25-mile diameter. It's visible from space and has been used by astronauts as a visual landmark. Scientists have described it as a very symmetrical and deeply eroded geological dome. It has captivated the scientific community for decades, with some claiming that it's proof of high-velocity extraterrestrial impact. Fringe researchers have argued that it's proof of the lost city of Atlantis. However, evidence gathered from the rocks indicates that the eye was created through a natural process involving volcanism and erosion. Some of the sedimentary rocks at the circle's center date back well before the appearance of life on Earth. The formation of the eye is believed to have begun at a time when the supercontinent Pangaea started breaking up. Before we move on, official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. It's out of this world. Number 3. Spinosaurus. With a length of 40 to 60 feet and weighing between 8 and 23 tons, the Spinosaurus is the most promising contender for the title of largest land carnivore ever. It was a theropod dinosaur, meaning that it belonged to an order of prehistoric predatory giants alongside the Tyrannosaurus and the Giganotosaurus. Yet, the Spinosaurus didn't really resemble its fellow theropods. It looked more like a cross between a crocodile and a T-Rex and fed mostly on fish. Its skull was long and narrow, its limbs were somewhat longer and flatter, and it had a huge, bony sail on its back. The fossil finds seem to indicate that the massive Spinosaurus was the only truly semi-aquatic dinosaur. It lived in North Africa about 112 to 93 million years ago. It became known to the world from a partial skeleton discovered in Egypt in 1912 and dubbed Spinosaurus aegypticus. These remains were subsequently destroyed during World War II, however, additional neck vertebrae were found in Morocco in the early 21st century, a possible indication of a different species which was named Spinosaurus moroccanus. Number 2. Stone Age Gravesite. At the end of the last ice age, thousands of years ago, people started living on the edges of the Sahara. At the time, it was a much greener and wetter place than today. The Kiffians were a prehistoric people that inhabited the Sahara 10,000 to 8,000 years ago. In the early 2000s, numerous human remains from this culture were found in the desert at a site called Gobero in Niger. It's the largest and earliest Stone Age gravesite ever found in the Sahara. The Kiffians were a tall and heavily muscled people standing at over 6 feet, with some measuring up to 6 feet 8 inches. They were highly skilled hunter-fishers, as some of the artifacts associated with the culture include bone harpoons and hooks. They lived on the shores of a lake most likely formed during a period called the Holocene wet phase. 8,000 years ago, when the Sahara started going through a dry period, there were no more traces of this culture. Gobero also revealed the remains of the Tenerians, a culture believed to have succeeded the Kiffians and settled the area about 1,000 or more years later. They were a nomadic herding culture that was physically smaller and less robust than the Kiffians. Artifacts associated with them include ceramics, arrowheads, bone, ivory, and shell ornaments. The earlier burials at the Gobero site were performed with tight constriction of the legs, which had been bound towards the chest with animal skins or other bindings. The later burials feature remains decorated with jewelry, a man buried with a turtle shell, and a mysterious family grave. The grave went back 5,300 years and featured a woman and her two children, which had been buried together. Pollen residue indicated that they had been laid on a bed of flowers with their arms entwined as if they were hugging. What's even more mysterious is the manner in which they had died. They did not suffer violent deaths, nor did they die of a plague, and they seem to have perished within 24 hours of each other. So, what function did the NABTA stone serve? If you chose B, astronomical devices, then you're right. The stone circle constructed in the 5th millennium BC was approximately aligned with the summer solstice, close to the beginning of the rainy season. In the years that followed, more stone structures were erected that may have corresponded with the alignment of Alpha Centauri, or the Belt of Orion. Number 1. Basilosaurus. About 90 miles southwest of Cairo, there's a UNESCO World Heritage paleontological site called Wadi El Hitam. It's incredibly important for the scientific world because it has provided evidence of how whales transitioned from land to marine creatures millions of years ago. Because of this, the site is also known as Whale Valley. About 50 million years ago, when the Sahara looked nothing like it does today, primitive whales called archaeocetes first took to the sea. Hundreds of skeletal remains belonging to this animal group were found at the site, but the greatest discovery came in 2015. That's when the first complete Basilosaurus skeleton was discovered at Wadi El Hitam. The 60-foot-long fossil was considered to be a remarkable find that provided further insight into the lives of prehistoric whales. Inside the Basilosaurus's rib cage, where the stomach would have been, researchers found the remains of other fish species, as well as those of another whale. Initially, they believed that it was either an unborn Basilosaurus fetus or the beast's last meal. The latter was proven true, as the remains were attributed to Dorodon, another prehistoric whale which Basilosaurus preyed upon. Based on evidence found in the Sahara Desert, scientists determined that the Basilosaurus was an apex predator with a bite force of about 3,600 pounds per square inch. it was one of the planet's largest creatures within the time frame of the Cretaceous-Paleogene extinction event 66 million years ago, and 15 million years ago when modern whales started reaching gigantic sizes. The Basilosaurus had an eel-like body and measured anywhere from 59 to 66 feet in length. The skeleton unearthed at Wadi El Hitan showed evidence of scavenging, or predation, by large sharks, the ancestors of the megalodon, arguably the largest predatory shark in existence. Thanks for watching. Would you rather spend a week in the Sahara region at the time of the Spinosaurus, or try to survive its current desert climate for a month? Let us know in the comments section below.